Hello, so it's BTP Liam here, and it's a cold day today. You can see some spots of snow in the air, so it's obviously quite a cold one, but it's not putting us off. We're going today to East Tilbury Battery and also Coalhouse Fault. So I'm going to start off looking in the battery and checking out the tunnels. They're very good indeed, and they're 126 years old. And we've got here today, we've got Jack, we've got Sam, who are joining us on this good trip. It's probably going to be one of the best trips yet. We've been here once before, and it's certainly a good place. So, see when we're in there. So we're here at the battery, Coalhouse Battery as it was called. It's quite near Coalhouse Fault, but it's not actually part of it. It was built in 1887, probably just to defend Britain. I mean, they've had a lot of wars at that time. They had the Napoleonic War before then, and they had the First World War just around the corner. So defences were probably quite an important thing. And you can see that this design was quite innovative because it used a metal fence as its only defence, and that was quite a breakthrough in technology, believe it or not, because usually they'd do big ditches and all sorts of quite sort of medieval methods of keeping people out, whereas this one, it just had a really good unclimbable fence as it was in those days. Another reason why it was innovative was because it faced down the Thames rather than across it. Because of the new guns, they could shoot a lot further, so it could cover the distance of the Thames rather than just from one side to the other. Right, so we're in the battery, we've just been in there. It wasn't really tunnels as such, more just one room, but it did have the cartridge lift underneath, and the idea is they'd put the bullets in there, or the cartridges, probably about that big, and it'd roll up on a sort of pulley, which you can see here in this photograph, and they'd feed through to the guns on the roof, where they'd be fired out. And that was quite advanced technology in those days, and it's quite a clever idea, even in these days.
Well, where'd we go?
Despite the terrain being very overgrown with thorns and steel nettles, we still managed to battle through and eventually get to the tunnels. Now, we did try our best to film it, however, due to the dust and dirt in the tunnels, the footage didn't come out that well. However, you can see here that we are using our torch in there. We do recommend that if you do visit the site, to take breathing apparatus and also a torch with you.
Hello, so here we are now. We're at one of these sort of, what do you call it, gun emplacements. And you can see the old lift there. And the gun would be there in the middle. You've got the little bolts that would probably secure its base into the ground. You've got these chains which probably would have stopped the recoil of the gun from like smashing into the side of the bit or something like that. There are these little metal walkways. I think we've got to be a bit careful of those because they've been here for 126 years, so perhaps it's best not to use those. But it's a very interesting place. We just went down in the tunnel. And we're trying to get some footage of the next one. Really good this. So, and by the way, there's four 6-pounder guns, which would have been smaller guns. And there would have been two of those on this side, this one, the next one. Two 6-pounders over the far end, and there'd been two £10 guns in the middle. I don't really have a clue about them, but you know, just saying what I read in the book last night. So.
And they will be on our interactive map on the website. Link is on your screen.
Yeah. So. Well then.
Starting to snow again now. So. Yeah. Gonna battle the dusty tunnels. Okay, so come across this hut, and we've got our little historian, Sam Hill, here. Sam, what do you think this little hut area is?
I reckon this is a cafeteria, like ancient time cafeteria. We've got a stove here, which looks like a stove to me. So you'd have your fire going on down here, and whatever you're cooking up there. So, you know, a bit of a stove going on there, and a table to eat your meal on. Quite nice. What do you reckon, Mr. Joe?
I reckon it could be. There's nothing really in the room to indicate as such what it could be apart from that bit. Like, there's nothing in the windows or whatever. So, yes, I'd say that's a reasonable explanation.
Nice. Now, you reckon this is the cafeteria, Joe?
It could be the cafe. The area there where Sam's standing could have been like a stove area. Going up to a chimney up there.
It does look to be like a scorch mark down there, so you know. Yeah. It could be two cafeterias, like a mini hot pot with like hot bar to keep the food warm, and this is where they actually cook the food.
And the hook's going to be where they like hung up meat and stuff.
This is the room to it next door, which is exactly identical to it. It's got hooks along there, marks along there. The stove area here, however, it's not burnt at the bottom. However, it looks a bit black up there. What's up the hole, dare I look? Just a really, really long tunnel.
Such fun.
No, where to?
That is big.
That's a
that's
deep as well.
Yeah.
Do you want us to get down there?
Well, if you want, or we go around the side.
Well, it's easy to get down there.
So this a £10 gun, emplacement. You'd have two of these. One here, one just along the way, and then your £6. You'd have two of them either side. £10 obviously be a lot bigger, heavier guns. So they would have been in there facing up and out. Sort of imagine bombarding the Thames there. We've got some of the sort of general facility rooms down there. Gonna check out in a minute. Just gonna try and work our way down here. There's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. So we've just come out of the £10 battery. We're now in the two of the buildings which are placed nearby. This area is the toilet area, and can you see that slate has been used to make the toilets? And it's quite a common material in the Victorian times. The next block, we're not sure exactly what it is actually. Looks like some sort of storage, fairly dark.
There's a shelf here.
Might be a bedroom.
Who knows, could be the sleeping area, yeah.
Yeah.
Or the plot.
Or perhaps it's there.
In this room behind us.
Through there, there's some sort of benches in there. Like stone benches.
Yeah, I think that's the stuff kids have made though. Not sure.
It doesn't look like kids have made that. Because the bits of stone are like too precisely cut.
Yeah.
That bit's on the roof where we've just been. You see pictures now of us on there.
This was obviously brought in by someone else, but yeah, there's like a little stove cooker thing there.
We saw that before, and that bit's part of a chimney.
Oh.
And then people might recognise that scene as where me and Liam had our picture taken.
So, it's quite cold. I mean, you can see, look at that. I mean, the snow is just coming down. It's February. We're just looking at the wood there and thinking how good condition it is. I mean, it's probably got to be original, but it really doesn't look it. It's just so good quality. Here, though, we have an interesting design feature. And you can see there's that sort of hex... scoring of sort of zigzag crisscrossy pattern on there, and you can see that a bit of this has come away from here. So I'm guessing that zigzag would be a method of making that bond to that more. I mean, if you're ever into clay sculptures or anything like that, then you know about score and slip method, which is you score both surfaces of the clay and you get some clay water. Put it between the two and sandwich them together, and the scores in it helps it to like stick and it doesn't pop in the kiln. We're guessing this is probably something to do with that, probably just to stop it from breaking away as easy over time.
It does look, you see over there, it's just the ground, it looks like we're not that high. If we look down there, we are high, just the rooftop there, you know, just a little hop over really.
Yeah, I mean. You're not gonna go all the way around there, are you?
Oh no. And then down here. Oh, it's another sort of deep hole. Sort of wind's picking up, it's a bit, you know, sort of scary. These are for massaging your feet.
I'm not actually gonna sit in there, Kat, it's just gonna be quite scary.
There's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky.
Ow.
Think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. See me running.
Okay, so some slightly less impressive jumping there. I promise you that's the last time you're going to hear I Believe I Can Fly in this video. Okay, so then after this we did move on and we ventured into the tunnels.
This, Sam,
it's another shaft.
What?
There it is. Us on the camera can't really see it.
Hello, so it's B2P Liam. Here we are in the tunnels. This will be under the 10 pounder, but it's a much bigger tunnel. Now, these are light shafts. We discovered that thanks to the help of
someone who decided it would be a good idea to put their own light in here, a little tea light. That's obviously not original, that's probably very new. But the actual shaft would have been four lights because you can see the little hole in the top where the light would be, where the steam would be escaped through, so it didn't steam up the base. Right, so if you just want to now have a look around the tunnels.
You see there on the wall, right in, the ammunition lift. Go there.
That's 6-2. Is that 8-2?
V2 or something? Dunno.
These are V.
But one good thing about these tunnels is that most of the prints on the wall are intact.
It was a V, Joe.
It was wood up there. Original. There's more of the wood over there, like the actual planks that come down.
Oh, yeah.
Over on that side.
You can see from here. Can you see? Oh, yeah, no, I saw, yeah.
Different texture on the wall here as well, which is wood as well.
Yeah,
no,
little
not wood
chips.
Even.
It's like wood, it's wood chips.
Cork set into the tarmac or something. Yeah. Now, here we are at the ammunition lift, the hoist. This one here. You either turn this crank all jarred up now, I'm sure. You never know, you could be lucky. Oh yeah, but you turn that, that'd be heavy work. And you put your bullets in there, and that'd lift them all up to the roof, and fire them off. I'm not sure what kind of lighting they would have in the day. Perhaps it's lantern light, or, oh no, candles or lanterns in here, of course. That's quite obvious. So, we're now going to come out. Yeah, I've got a picture of this. Just for this thing.
Use your flash. So we're in another one of the room bits now. You can see on the floor the sort of design of it there, sort of zigzag. And bricks there, which probably remains of a fireplace, which would have gone up there. You can actually see up through the pipe.
Someone down there would winch up the shells, pick it up from there, take it over to the gun, put it in, close it up or whatever, and then fire it ready. You can see the Thames out there. You can even see Corrington Refinery, it's the anchor there. This bit here, some sort of chute, similar to a hoist, but it wouldn't have been a hoist. I'm not sure what it would have been actually, but...
looks like it's got hinges on it.
Perhaps it's like some sort of just communication to just shout.
Yeah, rolling off another one. Maybe it was a waste one, because you had empty shells going up around here, didn't you?
Right, so you can see here what they would have done by putting in the shell, putting it up, and then it would have gone on the shaft, which goes up to the surface.
And this one's the only one that we've found so far that does actually move.
It's a good old one. You see roughly in it here the size of the shells and what it would have been. But, yeah.
Right, let's go.
Joe?
Mule?
So, what's this one?
Just a room for something.
So here we are now, we're outside. This is one of the 6-pounders, the last one in fact. We're now going to move on to Coalhouse Fort and a few of the cool World War II bits left around it. So, it's been good, the town's really cool. We'll see you later.